Today at 2 day pass, I'm following the sign to Rainer's Lane. I've completed one roundabout, going straight ahead, and we're on number 7 of the 10 most common reasons for failing your driving test at any test center, but I'm on an independent route doing this whole series here, following the signs to Rainer's Lane. Now, earlier on part 8, I was talking about response to road markings, and that was about the bus lane. I'm going straight, second exit, use the left lane. And then on part 8, normal driving. Here we have normal driving. Response to road markings, the bus lane. I can use the bus lane at this time. It's 2 p.m. and this bus lane is not enforced at 2 p.m. If you don't know this, you don't use the left lane, you don't exit into the left lane, you could potentially fail for position normal driving, which was on the last video. Now we're on to number 7. Make sure I get my numbers correct. And the next reason, or next most popular reason for failing the driving test, is move off control. Now, there's no way I'm going to fail that in this car. Why? If you are a subscriber to this video, thank you very much, and you'll probably know how much I dislike manual cars now. There's a couple of reasons, and no, it's not because I can't drive a manual, so forget that one. It's because we're in the 21st century now and manual cars are really a thing of the past. Why do you want to drive a manual car? If you don't need to drive a manual car, don't drive a manual car. Driving a manual car in traffic is a nightmare. Now, that's the reason why so many people, because we're getting higher up the list, we're on number 7 now. Actually, this may come up, I won't spoil the, no spoilers now, but this may come up again further up the list. So moving off control, how are people gonna fail in that automatic car for move off control? They're not. How are they gonna fail in a manual car for move off control? By stalling the vehicle. Now I'm gonna pull in here. This isn't a space that your examiner will ask you to pull into because it's too narrow. I'm just pulling in here to make the video shorter. Now I've got about half a car length in front of me. However, on your driving test, at some point, the examiners will ask you to pull in and leave about a car length from you and the vehicle in front. This will make it even more difficult for somebody in a manual car, especially, to move off. This is called an angled start. This is where the clutch control, hence move off control, will really come into practice. Way too many people, and I taught manual for about 8 years, before my whole body disintegrated from being chucked around and stalled and moving off in third gear, thinking it was first gear. Look, I'm not gonna go into a rant, but this is where the clutch control comes into practice. If you do not have impeccable clutch control, especially on a driving test where you're extra nervous, you're most likely gonna stall. Now, stalling will not necessarily fail you, but if it was a repeated stall, say 3 times over, yes, this minor fault can go into major fault. So a repetitive minor fault or concurring minor fault can actually consist of going into a serious fault at the examiner's discretion. So I'm going to use my left foot. You can't see it, but I'm imagining there's a clutch there. When you raise your clutch up, all cars are differently. This is why manual cars are so frustrating. You'll roughly get up about 2 inches, okay, about a thumb length, and then you'll reach where the biting point normally is, depending on cars. Toyotas are very low, Fords are very good, they're roughly in the middle, and then some other vehicles are way up, really high. Actually, saying that, I was in a Ford Focus not too long ago, and the biting point was way up high at the end. Okay, I'm not a mechanic, not getting into that detail, but you've got to know where your biting point is. You got to feel it. So when you raise your left foot up, you find that biting point, you hold that. Now, when people move off, hold the biting point, make sure you know it's safe, and then you move off. Sometimes people then jump the clutch. Jumping the clutch isn't going to stall you necessarily. It can, so make sure you set the gas. But if you jump the clutch, that power is going to go immediately into the vehicle. And a lot of people tend to then go veering off into the oncoming lane, and that could potentially be a serious fault for move off control. I'm going to move off now in an automatic car, and watch how easy this is, right? Yeah, safe. Okay. Oh, just a little bit of gas. Oh, that's nice. Ooh. Ah, welcome to the 21st century. Okay, guys. If that annoyed you, give us a thumbs down. All right. If it didn't and you're lighthearted like I am, hit that thumbs up.